Dear viewers, good morning to all of you. In this video, we'll see about the solution for GE8152 Engineering Graphics, Anna University, December 2019, Forenoon question paper. I'm Dr.M.Senthil Kumar. In this video, I'll be displaying the question and the solution for that question, the answer for the particular question in slide format. Okay, even though it is being played as video, the question and the answers are still images. So you can pause the video, see the answer for the given question, get to know the details, thereby you can understand to how to get the solution for the given question. Sometime I will be speaking and explaining, sometime I will be silent. Okay. Question number 1A. There is a question. We'll see the answer for that. So this is a question actually, okay, from the given question. This is the solution for it. Okay, here this is the focal point or the fixed point. It is called F, capital F is called the fixed point. The F is the fixed point. Okay, with respect to the fixed point only, everything has been given. The fixed point is 50 mm from the fixed line. The AB line is fixed line. So, okay, it is called either as fixed line or the directrix. So capital F is 50 mm away from the fixed line. And also in the question it is given that the between C and F, the D is at the midpoint. That is why, that is what is given in this particular problem. So CD equal to DF. So eccentricity is equal to DF by DC equal to 1. If the eccentricity E is 1, then the curve obtained is a parabola. Okay, so pause the video. Okay, you know the standard procedure. If you have any doubt, you please go through my previous videos where I have explained the solution to how to get the solution for this particular problem in detail. So get to know the things from my previous video, correlate that with this particular slide, you'll understand how you can get the solution for it. Okay, so this is the curve obtained. And on point P, you have to get the draw the tangent through the point P onto the curve. Again, there is a standard procedure. Pause the video. Okay, see the answer. Then refer my previous videos or the textbook. You'll get to know the, you'll understand the solution. Next question. This is given to you, this pictorial drawing is given to you for this by freehand. You have to draw the front view, top view and left side view. So for this question, I showed the 3D model using SolidWorks software here. Okay, so that is the solid model for the given question. We'll see the answer. This is the answer. Pause the video, see everything in detail. All visible edges are drawn by thick continuous line type. I use red in color, right? All the hidden edges are drawn by thick dashed line type. That is also red in color. Okay, we'll move on to the next question. A line PQ is inclined at 35 degrees to VP, has its ends 25 mm and 55 mm above HP. The length of the front view is 60 mm and its vertical trace VT is 15 above HP. Determine the true length of PQ, its inclination with HP and its HT. That means inclination of with HP means theta, then inclination of HT means it is angle of top view maybe. So this is a given question. In my view, okay, this problem cannot be solved by rotating line method. This rotating line method alone is there in the Anna University syllabus. Okay, so you please correct me if I'm wrong. If you are able to get the answer, you please correct me. I'll take it. Okay. So this problem cannot be solved by rotating line method as per the syllabus. But at the same time, the same problem can easily be solved by trapezoid method, but unfortunately that is not in the syllabus. Okay. So this is the problem or the difficulty that you have to obtain the solution, right? But don't worry, in spite of all the difficulties, I got the solution under the same rotating line method, not by just drawing. I use a SolidWorks software. With that only you can get the solution for this particular problem under the rotating line method. So this is for information. Shall we see the SolidWorks, the answer obtained from the SolidWorks software for this particular problem under the rotating line method? Okay, let us go. So this is the solution. Okay, so I'm afraid I'm not able to give you the solution in step by step to complete the drawing, because it is not possible by rotating line method. You put the notations. Okay, that is, this is P dash, Q dash, Q1 dash, Q1, P, Q, Q2, Q2 dash. Of course, the true length is 73.25. It is exact value since it is obtained from the software, CAD software. The theta is 24 degrees. The angle of HT is 39 degrees. The angle of HT is also equal to angle of the top view, that is beta. Now we'll see the solution for the same straight line problem under the trapezoid method, but that is not in the syllabus. Okay, whether we have this method in the syllabus or not, we'll see the answer. For this, I'll tell you the steps. Okay, so from the given question, you see one end is, left end is 25 above. So from here, mark this point. This is nothing but P dash, which is 25 above, right? After that, draw a locus, this line, which is 45 mm above. On that only Q dash must lie. This point is Q dash. So to, before getting the point Q dash, draw a locus, okay, parallel to XY line at a height of 55 above or 55 from the XY line. After drawing the locus line, it is given that the front view is 60 mm. So set the compass at 60, okay, with respect to this point, draw arc, get the point. This is Q dash. Now complete this, you obtained front view straight away. After that, the next step is you just extend the line this way, then you go through the problem. The VT is 15 mm above HP. So from XY, draw a another locus which is 15 mm above XY. So thereby this extension and this locus will meet at one point, that is nothing but vertical trace. Okay, the VT point is marked now. Then go to the question now. Again, go back to the question. The line PQ is inclined at 35 degrees to VP, that is pi. Pi is 35. Under the trapezoid method, if you draw a line which is 35 degree inclined with respect to the front view line, thereby you can get the true length. The true length after drawing the line, after draw the 35 degree line with respect to this front view line, with VT as the fulcrum point or the starting point. After that, through these two points, P dash and Q dash, draw lines that is perpendicular to the front view line. Thereby you can get this point and that point. Okay. So measure this distance, that is nothing but the true length. So true length is obtained now. Okay. Then the next step is draw a projector, draw a projector, draw a projector, draw a projector. On that, to get this point, set the height of this one, okay, and mark it here. To get this point, take the height of this one, this line, and with respect to XY, mark it. Thereby you can complete the top view. Thereby you can complete the top view. Okay, thereby you can complete the top view. Then after that, draw lines through the P and Q, perpendicular to PQ, small PQ, draw lines first, then take this height, height of P dash from XY, mark it here. Take the height of PQ dash, the Q dash from XY, set that height on this particular line. You'll get this point. Join these two. Okay. Again, this shows the true length. If you measure this angle is nothing but the true inclination with respect to HP. That is 24 degrees. So theta equal to 24 degrees. To get the HT, HT is not asked here, but anyway, you have to measure it. Okay, you extend these two, of course, you have to measure the angle of HT also. Okay, so you extend this line and the top view length, these two will intersect at one point, that is nothing but the horizontal trace. Measure its angle. You mention that angle in your answer. The angle of HT is 39 degrees. Okay, so this is how you can get the solution for this particular problem under trapezoid method so easily. Now in the next slide I'll show you, let me superimpose the answers obtained from both rotating line method and the trapezoid line method, so this is the solution obtained straight from the SOLIDWORKS software, because analytically we cannot solve the problem, I told you already, but analytically we can solve the problem under the trapezoid method. So this is the solution by trapezoid, this is the solution by rotating line method. Now I'll play the video. Okay, so thereby I'll be moving the entire trapezoid content. I'm superimposing with respect to the VT point. So this is the VT point here in this solution, this is the VT point in this solution. Okay, let me play the video.
Dear viewers, here I will superimpose the solutions obtained both by rotating line method and the trapezoid method here. Okay, so that you will have an idea about both the methods will give you the same look, same value. Okay, so this is the answer obtained by the rotating line method, and this is the answer obtained using the trapezoid method. Okay. Now I'll zoom in. So this is the rotating line method. This is the trapezoid method. Okay. Now let me move the entire solution obtained by the trapezoid method, and I am about to superimpose this with the rotating line method solution. Okay, so I use the thing called the move option. With respect to this vertical trace, I'll be moving the entire diagram. Okay, now let me zoom in. You see both the front view and top view absolutely superimposed, actually. Right, even the HT point and the VT point superimposed. So everything is superimposed. So whether you follow a rotating line method or the trapezoid method, the appearance, the solution and the values are exactly one and the same. Thank you.
The next problem, a regular hexagonal lamina of 25 mm side has one of its edges on HP. The surface of the lamina is perpendicular to VP and inclined at 40 degrees to HP. Draw the three views, that is front view, top view and one side view, and also locate the traces. Okay, here I have to not only show the front view and top view, I have to show one side view also. Okay, now to start with, start from the top view, draw the wherein the hexagon is placed this way, so then the 1/6 edge is perpendicular to XY or perpendicular to VP. So with respect to that only, we will be tilting it so that that edge will be resting. Okay, so this is the initial top view and front view. Then from the given data, till this first front view through 40 degree, get the second top view. Of course, this is the horizontal trace. Okay. So that is the solution for this particular problem. To get the side view, this here I have drawn the left side view. As per the first angle projection, you know very well that the left side view will appear to the right of front view. So draw x1, y1. That is a standard procedure to get the side view combining the top view and front view. Okay. As I said earlier, pause the video. Okay. Then see the answer in step-based, see the answer clearly. So thereby you will get the idea about how to get the solution for this particular problem. We'll go to the next problem. Hexagonal pyramid of base side 25 mm and height 60 mm is resting on its base in HP with its axis perpendicular to HP and one of the base edges perpendicular to VP lying on its left. Draw front view, top view, side view, right side view. So right side view means as per first angle it should appear in the left side of the front view, to the left of front view. So it's a simple position solid. Okay, so pentagonal, this is the pentagonal pyramid resting on the base. So base is seen in top view. I have drawn this in top view. Then one of the base edge is perpendicular to VP. So ED base edge is perpendicular to XY, perpendicular to VP, and it is on left side, not on the right side. Okay, so with respect to that, complete the front view. Then draw X1, Y1. Follow the standard procedure of getting the side view, especially the right side view here, right, and complete it. You have to use the notations like A double dash, B double dash, O double dash, and so on for the side view. Okay, as usual, pause the video, see the answer carefully. We'll move to the next problem. Draw the projection of a cone base 30 mm and axis height 50 mm resting on a point of its base circle in HP with the axis making an angle of 45 degrees with HP and parallel to VP. So this is a question. Again, the base axis is parallel to VP, right? So then you have to start from the top view, corresponding front view, till this front view such that the axis is inclined at 45 degree. Okay, by drawing projectors and horizontal lines you can complete the second and final top view. Then these are the extreme or tangent generator. It will not connect any of the 8 points that I marked here. It will be connecting the base circle somewhere between these 2 points. Okay, next problem. 4a, a cube of side 35 mm is placed and cut by a plane in such a way that the true shape of the section is a regular hexagon. Draw the sectional front and top views of the cube and find the inclination of the section plane with HP. It is a standard problem. For this, you have to start from the top view. In top view, draw the square such that all edges are equally inclined to XY, that is equally inclined at an angle of 45 degrees. So draw the top view first, the square which is 45 degree inclined. Draw the corresponding front view. Okay, to get the hexagon as the true shape, again follow the standard procedure. Between H dash G dash, mark the midpoint of H dash G dash, mark this as 3 and 4. Between A dash and B dash, mark the midpoint and mark that as 1. Okay, so then the cutting plane is start cutting from this point and exit at this point. Okay, it cuts the top face, so you will get 2 points. It cuts 2 vertical edges, again 2 points. It cuts base, again 2 points. 2 plus 2 plus 2, 6 points. So 6 points means it's a polygon of 6 sides. Of course, it's a hexagon. Of course, the angle, if you measure it, its angle is 55 degrees. Okay, the one main point is the cube size is not so important at all in this particular case, because even the cube size is 35 or 45 or 50 or 60 or x, this angle will be always constant, 55 degrees, irrespective of the side of the size of the cube. Pause the video, see the answer. Here the red color is given for the object, the magenta color is given for the objects removed by the section plane. We will go to the next problem. A vertical cylinder of diameter 40 mm and height 60 mm drilled by a hole of diameter 30 mm such that the axis of the hole is perpendicular to VP, parallel to HP and bisecting the axis of the cylinder. Draw the lateral surface of this development. Okay, first you draw the full cylinder, draw the full development, then introduce the hole in top view and front view, then get the points onto the development and trace it. So circle in top view, rectangle in front view, follow the parallel line method to get the development of the cylinder. Okay, so whose length is pi d, okay, 40 pi. Since I divided the circle into 12, divide this also by 12. Then all mark all the points, keep track on all the points and complete the holes, the front hole and the back hole. It is seen as an ellipse. Okay, we'll move to the next problem. A square pyramid of side 30, axis length 50, is centrally placed on top of the cube of size 50. Draw the isometric view. You are not asked to draw the isometric projection, you are asked to draw the isometric view. So you can take the value straight away. Okay, so follow the, draw a 30 degree line, 30 degree line this way, complete this rhombus. A square is seen as a rhombus in isometric. Okay, set the height 50, it's a cube, so 50, 50, 50, then complete this rhombus also, the square in isometric, find out the midpoint, with respect to midpoint, draw the base of the square pyramid, it is a size 30, okay, 30, 30, then from here, draw a vertical line, set the height as 50, so the apex is marked, okay, through the apex, show, draw and darken and show only the three visible slant edges. Okay, leave the hidden edges or make it as thin. Okay, next problem. A square prism 30 mm base side and 50 mm axis height is lying on the ground on its base with a face parallel to and 15 mm behind PP. The station point is 40 mm in front of PP and 60 above GP and lies in a central plane passing through a point 25 mm to the right of the right end of the prism. Draw the perspective projection of the prism. Okay, we'll see the answer. So this is a question. Trust that draw the square with respect to PP, the top view of the square prism. Okay, so with respect to PP, draw the square so that one edge or base side is 15 behind. So 15 behind. With respect to that, draw the square. Then with respect to PP, draw a GP line at a convenient distance. The convenient distance will be slightly more than the sum of in front of and above the station point. The station point is 40 above. Station point is 40 in front, 60 above. So 40 plus 60, 100, add 10 more maybe. So 110. So from with respect to PP line, draw a GP line which is 110 mm away or below. Okay. So with respect to that, draw projector and complete the front view. Here you know very well that we supposed to follow the third angle projection. So under by the third angle projection, top view at top, front view at the bottom. Then the central plane, CP line, is seen as a line both in front view and top view, which is 25 mm to the right of the right end of. So 25 mm to the right of right end of the solid. So 25 from here, mark, measure and mark 25 through that you draw central plane line. On it, mark the starting point S, 40 in front, S dash, 60 above. Okay. Then afterwards, you know, the procedures are standard. So connect all the top view points with S, all the front view points with A dash. Then through the intercept that you obtain on PP, draw projector and complete the final perspective projection. So this is the final perspective view of the spectral solid, the solid, which is nothing but a square prism. Okay. Now the one important thing is, in top view you see the line AB, the base side AB is parallel to PB or horizontal. So the same line AB, it's here, it is horizontal or parallel to PB. So AB, DC, 1, 2, 4, 3, all are parallel to PB or horizontal. If it is parallel to PP or horizontal, even in perspective, those are horizontal and parallel to PP only. Okay, you have that as a key, so then you can use this as a check. Okay, because while measuring and marking the angles and the distances, you may make some mistake. Even I will be making some mistakes, right? So with this point, so if it is inclined, you will come to know that you did something wrong, right? So pause the video, okay? Read the question and see the answer, you'll get to know more. Okay, so I thank you. I hope that you wrote the exam very well, okay? So you can use this as a checking tool, okay? Even for the first learners, you can get the details or the solution for the unanswered question paper. Thank you. Good luck.